I'd like to know what is your view on Islamic banking nowadays. People, many banks like HSB, Amna, and there are other institutions which support that we are into Islamic banking and loaning. So how halal it is to take a loan from them?
Brother has a question that what are my views on Islamic banking? Many banks have come up, HSBC has come up. We know as a general policy, as a general rule, that conventional bank, it deals with riba, deals with interest is haram. Personally, I won't speak on that. But regarding question, the Islamic banks that have cropped up, how Islamic are they? Tell you frankly, because of the system that we are, I don't know of any bank which is 100% Islamic. I don't know of any bank which is 100% Islamic. But some banks are more Islamic than the others. So you may have to do a particular survey on that. But today, there are various options that are given in Islamic banking. Musharaka is there. Then Murabahah is there, then Ijara is there. As far as Musharaka, partnership and all, no problem. As far as the system of cost plus Murabahah is concerned, there's a difference of opinion. In other aspects, Ijara, higher purchase, and partnership, profit and loss sharing, there's not much controversy on that. The major controversy we have today is on system of cost plus, where even I differ. I don't agree with most of the system of cost plus. And most of the Islamic banks, not all, the majority of the dealing is cost plus. If you go to the Hadith and the Quran, it hasn't defined how it has to be. Yeah, the basic guidelines are there. Interest is haram, riba is haram, profit loss sharing allowed. So on these basic guidelines, musharika, profit and loss sharing, all this is fine. But where cost plus comes, there's a question. So when you do cost plus and you try to compete with a conventional bank, you trap and ending in something like riba, but only catching the nose in a different way. So therefore the strict scholars, they say the cost plus Murabahah that is there, it is dangerous. Some say it's haram, some say some are haram, some say majority are haram. So I would say according to me majority are haram. So you have to scrutinize each case. So I can't give a fatwa on any particular bank per se. And I've spoken to many people running banks. And they find me too strict. They say, oh, Zakir is a fanatic. Me too. I said, yes, as far as riba is concerned, I'm totally against it. It is one of the biggest sins. And the hadith says that there are 70 levels. In riba, the lowest level is doing zina with your mother. So it is more bad than dealing with alcohol, dealing with drugs, etc., according to me. Therefore, if you work in an alcohol company, according to me, or in a drug company, cocaine company, it's a lesser sin than working in a bank. People say, oh, Zakir is too strict. I said, this is what I am, according to the Quran. Because having alcohol is haram, having drugs is haram. It's a big sin. But Quran says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse 278-279, that if you give up not the demands of riba, Allah and His Rasul will wage a war against you. So, this is a bigger sin even than alcohol and drugs. Therefore, I say, don't keep your money even in a fixed deposit or saving account and give in charity. Even that's haram. Why? Because first you have to take and then give it to someone. Quran says, taking only is haram. To give first you have to take. The moment you open a savings account or fixed deposit, you are signing and giving them permission to use your money on riba. So better than that, you invest your money in an alcohol company or a drug company, cocaine. Whatever profit you have given charity, you'll do less sin. I'm not saying that's allowed, no? Brother said that most of the salaries get came to savings account. Most. So why are you involved in most? Most of the people are doing shirk. You say, I want a current account. Tell to your company that open a current account. Now open a current account. Previously it was difficult, not that impossible. Now you get zero balance current account. Zero balance also. But put your foot down. But the bank does not like giving current account because they cannot use your money. If you give fixed deposit, 100% money they can use for a bar. Savings account, majority. Current account, they cannot, but yet they do, but very little. So why do they force you to give fixed deposit? When they give a fixed deposit, they're giving you 7%, 8% interest in India. Other places 6%, some places 5%. That means they should say they don't put, because they're losing money. The reason is because there are laws governing the bank. In fixed deposit, they can use 100% of your money. And when you sign, you're giving them permission. In savings account, they can use part, most of the majority. In current, they cannot, but yet they do use, not that they don't. So, but you aren't giving them authority, you are giving current account only facilitating your service. So therefore, best option is current account. If you have to keep money, otherwise don't keep in the bank only. keep current account. So your salary also, you can't say that the company forcing you. Tell the company, I want current account. It's not allowed in my religion. Simple. Open a current account. Fine. Hope that answers the question. Any sisters have any questions?